Good morning, folks. We'll hit a lot of key topics today and get some eye candy along the way. If it looks like the sun's got more active regions there, it does. Let's go to spaceweathernews.com and find the last day on the sun was without eruptive activity, absent on coronal holes too. But we've got brightness across the southern hemisphere and another one incoming top left. Those are indeed baby active regions, and we still don't expect much from them in terms of solar flaring at these early months of the sunspot cycle. In fact, we expect most don't even have sunspots beneath them. One of these does happen to have some dark spots spreading below one of the southern field arches. Solar wind is not only very quiet, but geomagnetic conditions are too. We almost had a KP0 day, but as it stands, we do have a minor cosmic ray health alert. Folks, Delta made landfall in the Gulf yesterday. Most of the images coming in are pretty rough, but this is the dissection of the clouds by the GPM, showing concentrations of precipitations. And we're getting the latest on asteroid Bennu as well from OSIRIS-REx. It's a rough and rocky world with a rotation period of only 4.5 hours. They've been able to map the thermal inertia of the body and also create a couple false color maps aimed at highlighting the detail they were able to observe. Up next, folks, we've got weirdly bad science. In attempting to determine whether the moon's crust is magnetized due to an internal dynamo or the interaction with the solar wind and interplanetary magnetic fields, they used micrometeoroids and claimed to have debunked all but the internal dynamo. Meteoroids, you say? How interesting. I thought we were gauging solar wind and interplanetary magnetic fields. This would be like looking at the clippings on the floor of Supercuts and trying to judge how good the haircut is. And when there are punctuations of long periods of quiet with ultra-intense interplanetary fields, it will leave an imprinted mark on the crust, just like it does in the rocks on the ocean floor. This was one of the better climate stories from January, solar forcing proven via tree ring analysis, and the same has now been shown for North America, and that they're connected. It's the same process, and if they are correlated, then they're correlated with the sun up in the north as well. By the way, that paper from January was the one that showed that South America's version of climate change so far has been nothing special at all. But let's go back in time to a genuinely serious climate change. In the wake of the Blake magnetic excursion 115,000 years ago, the grasslands in Southeast Asia suddenly changed to tropical forests. This was a key extinction epoch for the older megafauna and many human-like species. But it begs the question, however would high-latitude grasslands become a tropical setting so quickly? Hold that thought. We are going to magnetars up next, and they have found a record breaker. Not only is it the shortest pulsator known, not only is it insanely young at their estimate of 420 years old, but it showed evidence of a rapid spin down, a rotation glitch of the star. You may be asking yourself, how a star's rotation glitches? Well, in this case, it's due to the powerful magnetic fields, they think, and I think that's a great guess, because the two known causes of modern length-of-day glitches, or rotation glitches of the Earth, are geomagnetic jerks from the core or geomagnetic storms from the sun. We get both together to a terrible extreme every 12,000 years in one cosmic event, explaining how high-latitude grasslands could be thrust into the tropics, explaining how atmospheric depressurization could occur from a shockwave impact, instantly freezing mammoths as a tsunami of ice and mud wash over, and everything else from Hapgood to Einstein to Chan Thomas and everyone else who swore the Earth turns over. Everything about that is in our cosmic disaster movie and the playlist. We greatly appreciate your support. It is the last day for observers to win a MOVA Globe. Enter for free at the link below, and with our thanks for the gifts. We've got your wind maps and shots of our star to close, and of course, we'll do this all again tomorrow. Right here, but right now, it's 5:15 a.m. in the new Valley of the Sun. Eyes open. No fear. Be safe, everyone.